This is Krishnan here, President Rotary Club of Madras, Besant Nagar. Welcome you. This special meeting, which has been initiated by the district Rotarian Maithili. The meeting is called to order. Now I request Rotarian Arun to take over and conduct the proceedings. Thank you.
Thank you, President. I request Chairperson Maithili to commence the meeting.
Thank you, Arun. Welcome for being the MC today. A very good morning. Namaskaram to each one of you here. It's a very holistic program. Welcome you all to Bhagavad Gita. A life journey, a new initiative. I think the first initiative, one of its kind in District 3232. Thank you for Rotary Club of Madras, Besant Nagar, President, Secretary, and the entire members, and of course Arun, who was coordinating, for supporting this program. And when I saw Arun's, when I saw your club's invitation on Bhagavad Gita, I was really impressed. I thought, why can't this be a district initiative month after month? So I spoke to Arun, and everything has happened today. And by God's grace, I think this all these 18 chapters of Bhagavad Gita should be completed this year. So we have time till June 2021. I think we will be completing all the 18 chapters. And thanks to our speaker, who's going to be the star speaker for the entire session, Rotarian Kuppuswamiji, who's a very renowned, holistic person, a renowned Rotarian as well, who's gone abroad and lived many years and was, done so much of extensive work on peace also. So when I read his bio, I was really impressed, and I never knew he will even do a Bhagavad Gita. He even talks about Bhagavad Gita or even explain the summary. I was really, really taken aback. He's got multiple talents with him. Thank you, Kuppuswamiji, for being this speaker for the entire session. You would have wondered, many people even asked me after seeing the invitation, why Bhagavad Gita, how can Bhagavad Gita and peace go hand in hand? Because it is a life journey. Can you please mute yourself?
Sukanya, you need to mute everybody. I don't have that authority.
Yeah, Sukanya, please mute everybody, Sukanya.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Sukanya. So many people are asking why peace building and conflict, how Bhagavad Gita. I mean, they didn't question me. They were eager to know, because it's a life journey. And yesterday was Teacher's Day. So Gita is, given by Lord, Krishna to Arjuna. So it is somewhat, he preached everything about the worldly knowledge and everything. So it means, Bhagavad Gita literally means song of the God. It was a dialogue between Lord Krishna, as I told you, to Arjuna. It happened 5,000 years ago in a battlefield. And this is the, it examines questions, the basic questions of identity. Who am I? What is my life's purpose? Where can I find happiness and perfection in life? So throughout the session, I think you'll get answers for all these questions, and how peace will go along with the Bhagavad Gita, how we can be a better person in our, in this world, and serve the nation, serve the country and the humanity and the communities at large, also being a Rotarian. So this is all about making better persons, making us peaceful. If we are peaceful within ourselves, can we bring forth peace in the communities as well? So over to Arun Kumar for his proceedings. Thank you all for being here. I request you all to remain till the end. Also to put this program to all your friends and relatives to join this. It is going live on Facebook as well. Thank you for all of you for joining this program. Thank you.
Thank you, Rotarian Maithili, for a very good brief about this initiative. I really appreciate the efforts taken to spontaneously respond and take this forward today. I would like to introduce our guest. Of course, he doesn't need any introduction, but still, I think it is my duty to introduce him, our guest, who is going to inaugurate, is Dr. Sriram. Just give me a minute, please.
Dr. Dr. Sriram, I forgot to mention why I call Sriram is he's a very, very senior Rotarian in the district. He was a Peace District Secretary also during 2012-13. So who better person than Sriram? As well as his name is very nice. It resonates so well. Sriram and Lord Krishna and Bhagavad Gita goes hand in hand. That's why I called Sriram. And he immediately accepted to be our guest. Thank you, Doctor, for being with us.
Rotarian past president, Dr. Sriram has got hails from a family of Rotarians. His grandfather was PDG Rotarian K.V. Srinivasan, was the governor of undivided district 320, that is Tamil Nadu, Kerala and Sri Lanka in the year 1961-62. And he also donated nearly 96 acres and was instrumental in the starting of the medical college in Tanjavur. At Tanjavur, which was later adopted by the government. And the Rotary town in Vallam, Tanjavur was formed by PDG K.V. Srinivasan. His father, Ramdas, was a consultant engineer, was instrumental in renovation of many temple tanks. Professionally, Dr. Sriram is a ENT surgeon and a qualified practicing hospital and healthcare consultant, serving as a medical director to Work Hard Foundation. He's also a consultant to the 500-bed teaching hospital under Thane Municipal Corporation, Mumbai. Dr. Sriram began his Rotary journey as a Rotarian in 1995 and became the president in 2001-2. He organized Pramukh Gaurav, a great recognition to all past governors in the district. He was recognized with the Global Quest and awarded by Rotary International for membership development. And then he has also organized several vocational seminars and joint meetings and mega medical clinics. Shivananda Gurukulam, treating 1,000 patients by bringing many doctors for all the specialties. He has held many responsible positions within the club and district over the last two decades. The list is long. So for the convenience of everybody, I'm not reading everything, but he's got a checkered history as a Rotarian. So I request Rotarian PP Dr. Sriram to inaugurate this session.
Thank you, Rotarian Arun, and thank you, Chairperson Maithili, for inviting me for this program. And good morning to all the fellow Rotarians. Vanakkam. Maithili, I've been observing her for the past one decade, and whatever assignment she takes, she excels in that position. And we were used to wonder whichever assignment she takes, what she is going to do in that particular assignment. And she will make a very big mark in that particular avenue, and it will pave way for many, many other for successors to do a lot of programs in the avenue that she has taken up before. So today we have started this series of talks on Bhagavad Gita. As you know, it's also known as Song of God, which says, through meditation and a higher self is experienced. In Rotary Foundation, we do donate money to Mugam Theriyada, or Mugavari Illada, or a beneficiary number Kurukram. Namba Kurukra Panamanda, and maybe a beneficiary, maybe in Uganda, or bore pump, the Pana Yusagala. That is the beauty of Rotary. The gift is, the gift is pure when it is given from the heart to the right person at the right time and at the right place, and we expect nothing in return. Gita la vanda actually have three major themes: knowledge, action, and love, where peace prevails, gives us a unique way of life that eases you your tension and enjoy a happy and peaceful life. Actually, when we came to the world, you know, we brought nothing, and when we are going to leave the world, we are going to take back nothing. Even Alexander the Great, he was conquering the whole world, and before in his deathbed, he called his commanders and said, leave my hands outside my coffin when you are taking back my corpse, because I want the whole world to know this Alexander who conquered the world and earned so much of treasure is going to carry nothing with him when he is going back, leaving this world. Similarly, what Gita preaches, when actually when Arjuna, the whole concept of Bhagavad Gita came when Arjuna came to the war field and looked at Krishna and said, Lord Krishna, how can I fight in the war? My own uncle is there, my teacher is there, my periyappa is there, my cousins are there, my brothers are there. How can I hurt them? How can I kill them? Apada, the concept of Gita, the solli makes him understand. First vandu ஒரு ஒரு பாம்பு வந்து தம் உடம்புல இருக்கிற பழைய தோலை உரிக்கிறதுக்காக கல்லுல போய் கஷ்டப்பட்டு ஸ்கின்னோட வெளியில வருது. ஐ மீன் ஆடிபிள்.
யா யா யா.
எஸ் டாக்டர், எஸ் டாக்டர்.
அந்த மாதிரி அதே மாதிரி சி கீதால என்ன வாட் கீதா சாரம் சம்மின்னா, வி the body is like, you know, changing the clothes, atma is permanent. So even in Gita says that leaving the body is just like changing the clothes. Or padathula Rajinikanth kuda padirpaaru, kambukali thindravanum mannukulla thangapasvam thindravanum mannukulla, indha vaalkai amaidiyaga vaalvadharku than nam pirakkil idai kondu vandhom kondu sella. இதுதான் பகவத்கீதாவும் சொல்லுகிறது. த பவர் ஆஃப் காட் இஸ் வித் யூ ஆல் த டைம்ஸ், தோ த ஆக்டிவிட்டீஸ் ஆஃப் மைண்ட், சென்சஸ், பிரீத்திங் அண்ட் எமோஷன் ஆர் கான்ஸ்டன்ட்லி டூயிங் ஆல் த ஒர்க், யூசிங் யூ மியர்லி அஸ் அ இன்ஸ்ட்ருமெண்ட். அல்டிமேட்லி எவ்ரிபடி ஸ்ட்ரைவ்ஸ் ஃபார் பீஸ் அண்ட் ஹாப்பினஸ் இன் ஒன்ஸ் லைஃப். த ரியல் பீஸ் இஸ் அச்சீவ்ட் வித் த கிரேஸ் ஆஃப் காட். And in Bhagavad Gita, Lord Himself is directing directing us not to be carried away by the incessant desires. And in our life today, if we practice the seven basic principles of life, like, you know, truth, gratitude, forgiveness, love, humility, and patience, the peace will always prevail. And I don't want to stand, I'm very happy to inaugurate this session today, and we are all eagerly waiting to listen to the great speaker. And I once again thank Chairperson Maithili to having invited me and given me this opportunity to take part in this wonderful program. Thank you and good day to all.
Thank you, Doctor.
Thank you, Doctor.
I would like to brief about the program now. Basically, it will be a 40 minutes session by Rotarian, past president PHF Rotarian Puppu of our club, and followed by question and answer session. So you need to go through, wait patiently, and then you can put up questions at the end of the session. Meanwhile, I would like to briefly run over the topic of peace building, which is the peace building and conflict resolution, which is the subject matter of our session today. Very, 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 very briefly. Starting from the pre-World War I, since 1914, when Rotary International commenced operation, the main resolution was at that point in time calling for the maintenance of peace. So they had proposed that resolution at the International Association of Rotary Clubs, which later became Rotary International. Then the delegated adopted that, and then further in 1921 changed it to aid in the advancement of international peace and goodwill through a fellowship of business and professional men of all nations united in the Rotary ideal of service. Then, of course, we moved on to Rotary World War II, wherein the need for peace and conflict resolution gained paramount importance. And Rotary has been communicating the principles of peace building through its magazine called The Rotarian, and which culminated in 1944. Two books, to be honest, collection of essays carved out of the Rotarian magazine. It was called A World to Live In 1942, published in 1942, and Peace is a Process, published in 1944. So both recognized that the end of war did not eliminate the need to discuss these topics. So Rotary continued the series with Peace Demands Action in 1947. So today, so much so, nearly 8 universities are offering various peace fellowship programs across the world for Rotarians and sponsored persons to participate, graduate, and then which aims at establishment of peace despite the absence of any large-scale war across the world. So they have also established scholarships specifically for this purpose. So now I would like to introduce our main speaker, Rotarian PHF PG Kupuswamy. He is a mechanical engineer from Guindy Engineering College with specialization in hydraulics from Delft in Holland. He has worked in Wavin Group in India for 9 years and mostly in Holland for nearly 32 years and has traveled widely across the world. He has traveled to nearly 60 countries. His primary specialization was in the field of, or rather is in the field of plastic pipes and water management. Next to water management, his main interest is in learning and sharing Gita. And he started learning Gita at a very young age of 11 years when Kanchi Paramacharya visited his school, the Hindu Theological High School, and blessed him and made him join Gita Sangam. He has been a Rotarian in our club, Rotary Club of Madras Basanagar, for the last decade. And he is also a PHF member, apart being a past president. So I look forward to his discourse on the peace building and conflict resolution in relation to Bhagavad Gita. Over to you, Rotarian Kupu.
Thank you. Now let me share the screen. I think the organizer has to allow me to share the screen.
Yes, sir.
Arun, can you tell that?
Yeah, we are doing it, sir.
Only. 1 minute.
Yeah.
Hello. I don't have it right. I think Sukanya has to do it.
Oh, yeah. Yes, sir. 1 second.
Can I, Sukanya?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay. You are no co-host. Okay.
You are no co-host.
Yeah. You
okay.
Share.
Is it clear now?
Yeah, excellent.
Okay. Good morning, Rotarians, aunts, friends, brothers and sisters. Thanks for giving this opportunity. You already more or less whatever I'm going to present is already mentioned in the introduction speech and all things. Dr. Sriram has given an excellent introduction, more or less covering part of the speech. You think very good? Thank you so much. The thing, and the my, let's say, very interesting association with Gita is in our club, Basanagar club, more than 3/4 of the people are Krishna. the thing. So we cannot avoid Gita, number one. The present president, Krishnan, first lady is Gita. So our club president is Krishnan, first lady is Gita. How can I avoid Gita and Krishnan right now? So this is becoming a, let's say, part of life for me. So with this small introduction, I will start the thing. Today, it is summary of chapter 1 and 2, focusing on conflict prevention and peace building, as per the request from the district. So, Bhagavad Gita, first 1-2 slides on chapter 1, the rest of the presentation is chapter 2. There's chapter 1, there's nothing to talk much about chapter 1. Chapter 1, 45 verses, the name of the chapter is Arjuna Vishada Yoga, the grieving of Arjuna. It's an introduction to see where are we now. At the end of chapter 1, the situation is, in the Kurukshetra war, both Pandava and Kaurava army is lined up, ready to start the war. Lord Krishna parked the chariot in the middle, of Kauravas and Pandavas, at the request of Arjuna. Arjuna is completely drowned in the sorrow of samsara. I will explain that. Refused to fight relatives and gurus. He further argues as how a war and death will destroy families, values, dharma, etc., etc. This is the conflict within and loss of peace, not only for Arjuna, for all of us. In this introduction, I want a kind of a situation. We need a mindset up before listening to Gita. Many years, I made Gita presentation to the school student children in Netherlands. In Netherlands, many villages, towns, the school children study Gita. I have to make, at the request of my colleagues, the children, grandchildren are studying. I made presentation right from year 2000 in schools, in Bhagavad Gita, like this, by chapter. The first thing is, do you want to say that we should go and fight war? Is that the teaching of Gita? No. There I understood. And that is why I'm making this line. We need a mindset up before listening to Gita. Listen to Gita in today's context. We are not in the Kurukshetra, we are not fighting a war. In today's context, we listen to Gita and then take the meaning with respect to today's situation. Today, there is no war, no Pandava, no Kaurava, nothing in today's situation. The 5 Pandavas, what we are going to talk, are our 5 sense organs. Ear, eye, ear, nose, tongue, skin, pancha jnanendriyangal. The 100 Kauravas are many world objects and people. The constant conflict between the sense organs and then the world objects, what we see, what we should not see, what we eat, what we should not eat. This kind of a conflict and confrontation between the 5 sense organs and then several world objects is the war, Kaurava, Pandava war. This is how we take it. Our intellect tells the mind, intellect is the big boss director, tells the mind, who is the manager, to guide the sense organs so that our peace is not affected. This is the lesson. My intellect tells the mind to control the sense organs. This is how the Gita has to be viewed in today's context. The thing. When I said this to the children in Holland 20 years back, they said, oh, this is clear. Now you go ahead. That kind of thing. Now, definition of samsara. I mentioned is all this conflict causes samsara. Samsara is not Tamil samsaram, wife. The thing. Samsara is an emotional turbulence. In Gita, it is mentioned, in the beginning, it's mentioned that raga, that is emotional attachment, dependence. Then soka, the consequent grief of losing the attached ones. Moha, delusion, confusion, which is right, which is wrong, etc. This is a simple introductory definition of samsara. Samsara is universal problem, this emotional turbulence, not just Arjuna's. Meaning, internal conflict and consequent loss of peace. If you reduce conflict, you realize your inner peace. You will realize your own inner peace. Without your internal peace, you cannot give peace to anybody. Your aim is to give peace to the world. You can give only what you have. I don't have peace at all. I'm very disturbed. I'm very upset. I want to give a lot of peace to people. It is something like, I have no money. I've got hardly 10 rupees in my pocket. I want to donate 1,000,000 rupees. How can you do? Unless you have peace within you, you cannot give peace to people. So first, give peace, internal peace. Right. Four-step solution to samsara. This is how chapter 2 starts. First, recognize, diagnose the problem of samsara. You should know, you should diagnose that you have this problem. Recognize, self-medication will not help. I myself will solve the problem by doing meditation or reading this book, that book, and all the thing. No, self-medication will not help. Seek external doctor, external help, spiritual teacher. Seek this help from a spiritual teacher. Completely surrender to the Guru, accept his teaching, accept his medicine. These are the four steps to resolve samsara, the internal conflict. Since there's a doctor sitting, he will understand. Patients, if you have a problem, come to me. Please don't just take the medicine of your choice. Come and check with me. This is what Krishna started. Arjuna was in step number one, recognizing his problem at the end of chapter one. The topics to be covered in chapter two are the four. Arjuna surrender to Guru, Lord Krishna, verse 1 to 10. Jnana Yogya, in this chapter is called Sankhya Yogya. Yoga, verse 11 to 38. Karma Yoga, action, duty, verse 39 to 53. Sthira Prajna, the right translation, approximate translation is Man of Wisdom, verse 54 to 72. This chapter has got 72 verses. This is how it is split. Although the order to follow in our life is different, but Krishna mentioned in this. Right. We start with Sankhya Jnana Yoga, which is the first part in this chapter. What do you mean by jnanam? Self-knowledge. What is self-knowledge? We know many things in the world. I know about that. I know about computer. I know about aeroplane. I know about plastic pipe. I know about water. All those things, fine. Do you know about yourself? Oh. I don't know that clearly. Wise men differentiate between body-mind complex and Atma. To talk to many beginners, along with Atma, instead of Atma, I will use the word consciousness. The approximate translation, not absolutely perfect. Atma is consciousness, awareness. In Tamil, we can say unarvu, the thing. Your real nature is consciousness. Body-mind is an instrument to transact with the external world. It is like an instrument. It is like my mobile phone to communicate with people. It is like my computer to communicate with others. My body-mind complex. My real nature is consciousness, Atma, awareness, unarvu. The basic definition of Atma, consciousness, is inner, immortal, invisible essence of every living being. Inner, immortal, invisible essence of every living being, you, me, everyone. Its nature is pure existence, pure consciousness, pure happiness. In Sanskrit, Sat, Chit, Ananda. Sat is existence, Chit is consciousness, Ananda is happiness. All put together in our today's context, today's presentation, is peace. If you just take the word peace, P stands for pure, E stands for existence, A for Anand, C for consciousness, E eternal. It's my own interpretation. While typing, I got this meaning. Pure existence, Ananda, consciousness, eternally. This is peace. That is the Atma. That is the whole topic today. Your real nature. Your real nature is peace. That is it. Krishna teaches Arjuna to do his duty first without any conflict. Please do your job. Please, duty allocated to you. Please do that thing. Don't get confused. He tries to teach Arjuna in three different levels. As a class 5 student, class 12 student, and graduate student, is trying to do. Maybe in a different order, but is trying to do. It's the spiritual route, Atma-oriented. Since Atma is eternal, Akarta, non-doer, Abhokta, non-experiencer, why are you worried? You are not killing anybody, right? That is that route. But he suddenly realized Arjuna is not ready for that route, that level. He is only a 10th standard student. Then he changed it. Follow dharmic way, ethical route. As a kshatriya, ruler, administrator, you are supposed to uphold dharma. Take care of people. Take care of dharma and then destroy adharma. That is a duty of a kshatriya, ruler or administrator. He is trying to teach him in that route. If Arjuna is not recognizing even that route, because all the life he spent in forest, even a dharmic route or kshatriya route he is not able to follow, he says, okay. You come to the 5th standard. Worldly route, laukika way. If you back out now, what will happen to your image? People who want to follow Arjuna as a role model, what they will do? They will run away. You are a military, you are a policeman. No, I will not fight with anybody. I will do only prayer and sit in the corner. If you say, no, what is that? What your followers will do? Please do your duty. Whatever step is more relevant to you, followable to you, please take it and do that thing. Krishna does that in different parts of this chapter. Okay. Sankhya Yoga, Jnana Yoga says, you are not body, mind, you are the consciousness. Instead of Atma, I use the word consciousness. In Tamil, you take it as Unarvu, Thuya Unarvu. Consciousness is not part, product, property of the body. Consciousness is an independent entity which enlivens the body and pervades the body. Consciousness is not limited by the boundaries of the body. It is like a space and air. It is inside my body. It's also everywhere. That kind of thing. Consciousness continue to exist even if after the fall of the body. It is nityam, eternal. So even when the body falls, body dies, the consciousness survives. It is the rule number 4. 5, that surviving consciousness is not available for any transaction since the medium is not available, body medium is not available. I got a SIM card working very well, but my phone is broken. I cannot make any phone call. Phone is like our body, and the SIM card is like Atma. SIM card is perfect. It's work. It's very good, but the phone is broken. How do I call you? I cannot do the transaction with the world. In the consciousness cannot do transaction in the absence of the body medium when the body is gone. This is the five basic traits of consciousness. You can reflect it whenever you have time. Lesson to learn is to avoid conflict and build peace. That is the subject for Arjuna and you and me, for all of us. Krishna says that I am that consciousness. My real nature is that consciousness. You are that consciousness. He, she, they are that consciousness in real ultimate sense. He talks to everyone in that far field. What does it mean? I am consciousness, you are consciousness, she is consciousness, he is consciousness, they are consciousness. That means I is equal to you, is equal to he, is equal to she, is equal to they, it is equal to world. Arjuna, do you understand? That's how it goes. That's why about 18 chapters. End of second chapter, when Krishna asked Arjuna, did you understand? What did you ask? That's what it says. We are like Arjuna now. See, the basic difference in our understanding, body-mind on the left-hand side, Atma-consciousness on the right-hand side, body-mind is the object of experience. I experience the computer, I experience the world, I experience the car. Same way, I experience my hand, I experience my leg, I experience my mind, I experience my intellect. It's a body-mind, is the object of experience. And Atma consciousness is the subject experiencer. Body mind made up of matter, five elements. You all know the thing. Akasha, Vayu, Agni, Jala, Prithvi. Okay, we'll come to that later. Atma is spiritual non-matter. The body mind world has got three gunas. Sattva, Rajas, Tamas. It's all made up of guna. Many attributes. Color, this, that, everything. Atma is nirguna. Then, body-mind complex, including the world, is subject to change. It is like this tomorrow, it is like this day after tomorrow, it is something like this today. My body was some different 5 years back, my body is different today. My mind was turbulent yesterday, I am reasonably peaceful today. Everything changes. Atma, nirvikaram, non-changing. And body-mind world is subject to birth and death, beginning and end. Anything which has got a beginning, it has got an end. D-O-B, D-O-D, all those kind of things. Atma, anadi, nityam, eternal, eternal, eternal. That kind of thing. So, what I would like to claim as my real identity, the dying, incomplete, changing body, mind, or eternal Atma, we will decide the thing. Okay. In this chapter, Krishna starts with Jnana Yoga, about explaining consciousness. If Krishna asked me, I would have told him, no, don't talk to Arjuna. Jnana Yoga is not ready. This is for a postgraduate. Arjuna is in fifth standard. You go to Karma Yoga, but Krishna was a very kind person, his cousin Arjuna. He thought he is a brilliant guy or he is a very intelligent guy. He started with Jnana Yoga. Let's go in that order, but in our life, we'll take it in a different order of our ability. In this chapter, slokam 12 to 25, the Atma's traits are explained. I use the word Sanskrit and also English. Nityam, eternal, not born, not dead. Atma. Satyam, independent, existent on its own. It doesn't have borrowed existence. It is having an independent existence of its own. Sarvagataha, all pervading, like space. It is in my body, it's in outside, it is everywhere, including your body. Okay? Inside your body, outside your body. It is aprameya. Ever the experience, not the object to be experienced. Aprameya is the object of experience. It is not an object of experience. You cannot experience, you cannot understand, you cannot say, please define it. No, sorry. It is you, it is the subject. How can you define the subject? You can define only an object, the thing. Then Atma is akarta abhokta, non-doer, non-reaper of benefits, the thing. Nirvikara, no changes, the thing. You are this eternal consciousness. You are not killing anybody. Akarta abokta. Nobody is killed. So do your duty as a ruler. Don't bother. Don't bother. Keep on worrying. Don't do. Just go and do your duty. This is karma, jnana yoga part finished. Looking at Arjuna's face, Krishna understood. He started teaching a little bit too much for a beginner. So he went to karma yoga from verse 38 to 53. Out of the total 72, he started with the recognition of the problem, then jnana yoga, and then found not in the right order, went to karma yoga. Let's for a beginner. Arjuna is understood. Jnana yoga is a route to mukti or freedom. Freedom from samsara, freedom from bondage, freedom from expectation, freedom from disappointment. So, jnana yoga. But you cannot go to jnana yoga directly. You cannot go to 12th standard without passing through 5th standard. It's not possible. Although you are interested, you cannot do that thing. Karma yoga is the first step before going to jnana yoga. That's why karma yoga is called jnana yogyata, pre-qualification for jnana yoga. Karma yoga is a pre-qualification for jnana yoga. In simple language, karma yoga is the 5th standard, jnana yoga is the 12th standard. Just for it. Karma yoga train and discipline your mind to receive jnana yoga. So start with karma yoga, or the second chapter should have started with verse 38 to 53, what we can read whatever way we want, you know, that's no problem. So it is the first step, discipline your mind, without which you cannot go to jnana yoga. You cannot go to 12th standard without doing 5th standard. So one line definition of karma yoga is right action with the right attitude is equal to rotary. Right action with the right attitude. Do the right action, Rotarian, with the right mental attitude. That Krishna said, maybe he's a Rotarian. Okay. Some of them were already mentioned in my previous presentation, but I'll repeat it. What do you mean by right action? Sattvic karma is action where several people are benefited. The best one is a Rotary. Rajasic karma is action where I am the only one benefited. Just okay, the thing. Tamasic karma is action where I am benefited at the cost of someone else. Avoid. Sattvic karma best, Rajasic chalega okay, Tamasic avoid. Right action is a mix of more Sattvic karma, less Rajasic karma, and nil tamasic karma, where the simple word, please do an action where many people are benefited. As simple as that thing. Okay, I will do that thing. Instead of making, my usual example, making 100 chapatis and give it to 100 people. That's sattvic. Rajasic is I make one chapati, I eat myself. The thing. Tamasic is I don't make even that one chapati, I steal the chapati from next plate and eat myself. This is tamasic. So pay attention to more sattvic, less rajasic, no tamasic. Then what do you mean by right attitude? Okay. I am Atma. I am Akarta. Therefore, I am not the doer, my real sense. But I have not realized I am Atma yet. Still, I am thinking I am the body mind. But really, I am not the doer. My body is doing this. I am not the body. I renounce the doership. The meaning is what in our reference. Don't get over attached to I am doing, I am doing, I am doing, I am doing. It is not just the ego only. Most of our actions are not of, let's say, the best level. Always when you finish the action, when somebody asks you, are you happy with your action? No, no, I'm not satisfied. All the time we say, I'm not satisfied with my action. Therefore, the best way to avoid the confrontation is, I am not doing this. I am not doing this. Okay? I am doing it with the arpana bhavam. Do karma in the arpana bhavam, dedicating to God. He is doing, I am an instrument. He is a vegetable cutter. I am a knife. So if the vegetable cutting is not perfect, don't blame me. I am only a knife. Okay? I am doing as per his guidance. Do it in Arpana Bhava for a beginner too. Not to worry too much about what you're doing. Do your best. Don't worry too much. That's the meaning. Same way, Atma is abhokta, not a reaper of benefit. Therefore, the result, karma palam, is not mine. It belongs to the body. I'm not the body. I renounce karma palam. Renounce means I am not over attached to the results. I'm not over worried about the results. Do the best and take what comes out. Take karma palam as a prasada bhavam. This is the teaching of Gita. Karma, karma yoga in two lines. Right action, right attitude. Right action is do karma in the arpana bhavam, dedicating to God. Take the result as a prasada bhavam, gift of God. It is not for any kind of a, let's say, make somebody happy or anything, to make you a little bit peaceful. Otherwise, I'm always worried my quality of my job is not good and the result what I get is not satisfactory to me. I expected 1,000, I got 500. What a lousy world it is. What a lousy people it is. This kind of thing. So do the action in Arpana Bhavam. Take the result in Prasada Bhavam. Right attitude goes with the right action is Karma Yoga. Okay. If you keep on doing Karma Yoga over a period of time, doing the right action with the right attitude, reducing the doership attitude and also over attachment worry on the results, karma yoga, with the real understanding, dedicate karma to God, take the result as his gift, the thing, your mind is little bit purified, cool down. Previously, I was worried every day 100 times. Now I'm worried only 10 times a day, that kind of thing. So mind is purified, cooled a little bit to receive Jnana Yoga. You are pre-qualified to by Jnana Yogyata. This is the meaning of Karma Yoga. Over now, up to 53, this chapter going. This chapter is not talking about Upasana Yoga, meditation, that means it comes in chapter 6, but we include Upasana meditation is also a mental karma. Physical karma is action. Physically, I'm going and doing some work, giving something to some people is a physical work. Mentally, I'm wishing them all the best. I'm praying for them. It's also, Upasana is also a mental karma. That is also purifying and focusing your mind. We'll talk about that later. Let's take Upasana is also part of Karma Yoga, the thing. Sthira Prajna is converting knowledge into wisdom. I got fantastic knowledge, but I'm storing it. I'm not internalizing. I'm not using. No use. It is like having 1,000 songs in my computer, old Tamil Hindi song. Have you heard those songs? No. I'll hear it one day. I got stored it. The thing. That's like knowledge. Listening to the song and enjoying the benefit is the wisdom. Sthira Prajna, verse 54 to 72, is knowledgeable man to wise man, done in three steps. Shravanam, listening to the teachings of the guru. Mananam, reflecting the teaching, getting rid of the doubts, getting convinced fully. Nidityasanam is converting the spiritual knowledge into emotional strength, peace. These are the three steps. Remember the Tamil Tirukkural, Karka Kasadara Karpavai, Katrapin Nirka Adarku Taga. Karka is Shravanam, listening. Kasadara is Mananam, getting rid of the doubts. Nirka Adarku Taga is Nidityasanam, internalize and walk your talk. Don't keep on saying I'm very knowledgeable, but I'm not doing whatever I learned, that kind of thing. No. Nirka Adarku Taga, do what you learned. Okay, walk your talk. 1 + 2. Shravanam plus Mananam is a person with very good spiritual knowledge. 1 + 2 + 3 is a Sthira Prajna, spiritual wisdom, who has internalized, assimilated this knowledge, converted knowledge to wisdom. This is what Krishna explained. How to recognize a man of wisdom, Sthira Prajna. we should all try to become this thing by internalizing the knowledge so that we can transfer. It will come in the end of this thing. Few more slides. Is full and complete with himself. It does not need external emotional support. Less expectation, less disappointment. Therefore, he is free from binding desires. If something comes on his way, he enjoys. If it does not, he doesn't go after that thing. It's still okay. Samatvam. He maintains a good balance between good experience and bad experience. He does not dance with joy, does not cry from sorrow. Sort of balance maintaining. In short, his conflict, internal conflict, external conflict reduces slowly, slowly, slowly. Peace increases. When conflict is reducing, the peace will increase. The thing, throw away the conflict, the internal peace is realized. The topic today. So, Sirapragya, person with spiritual wisdom, has three qualities, what I mentioned in the beginning. Now it's revised. Raga, emotional attachment. Then bhaya. Bhaya means fear of losing the attachment, attached person or thing. Think. Krodha is anger on the person which has taken away my desired object. So the person with wisdom, okay, Sirapragya, is raga, bhaya, krodha are less and less and less. He who gained this self-knowledge sees everyone as himself, herself, and builds love, care, compassion. Reduction of fear, anger means building up of peace. How to become a Sirapragya? Sense control, mind control, meditation on what you learned. Convert the knowledge into wisdom. Three. Sense control. Avoid all the impurities entering your mind through the sense organs. Control what you want to get and what not. It is not a denial, it's only a control. You enjoy the object, let not the object control you. I enjoy my coffee, but coffee is not going to enjoy me. Be careful about that thing. Take charge of what enters you. Thought, words, action, desire, your attitude and personality. Develop positive thoughts, kind words, and noble action. Coming to Rotary again. Stable, positive mind help convert intellectual wisdom into an emotional strength. Knowledge, wisdom, and emotional strength is equal to peace, our topic today. Mind control continues. Mind is the origin of thought. Thoughts lead to the word and action. Thought enters through sense organs and comes from the old impressions in your system. If a negative thought comes, don't worry too much. Some people ask me, that's why this what thing added. Just ignore it. Only repeated thought result in action. Don't probe a negative thought. Just one time flash thought, if ignored, is harmless. Don't worry too much about the thing. Pure, peaceful mind is a requirement for gaining spiritual knowledge and the spiritual, let's say, wisdom. Fulfilled mind, controlled desire, balanced attitude towards external experience is the definition of Sirapragya, wisdom. The mind control and sense control fall in line with the Rotary four-way test. A pure mind, clean mind, expectationless contribution, that is, we are going back to that also. The whole Gita is Rotary. Nidityasana is meditation on your real self. Meditation lessons learned from Guru. Meditate that you are not the body-mind conflict. You are the pure, blissful Atma. Be aware, you are Satya, Nitya, etc., etc. Not only you, for everyone is this. This is what you should realize. Now, coming to conclusion. Chapter 2 talks of introduction to Karma Yoga, community support, and Jnana Yoga. You are the consciousness and everyone is the same consciousness. See everyone as you. Karma purifies your mind and Jnana Yoga liberates you. Meaning, you are free from conflict, dwell on internal peace. Free from liberate you means liberate you from the conflict. Internal conflict, external conflict. Jnana Yoga, self-knowledge, is impossible to start without going through Karma Yoga, preparatory mind purification. Karma Yoga alone is incomplete without Jnana Yoga. You cannot stop with 5th standard. You have to go to 12th standard anyway. Bhakti Yoga, many people ask this, that's why this thing, devotion to the ultimate truth, creator, is an integral part of both Karma Yoga, Jnana Yoga, Upasana Yoga, everything. Bhakti is involved in it. It's not a separate yoga. It is in everything. Work is worship. Whatever you do, it is bhakti. Worship is bhakti. Meditation is bhakti. Jnanam is bhakti. Everything is bhakti. So, summarizing, change from consumption to contribution in steps, little by little, and consequent bliss and peace. Gita teaches these, all these things in these two chapters. Service to humanity, purify your mind. Just to do your duty in an ethical manner. With pure mind, learn your real nature, consciousness, which is same for everyone. All are same, all are one. Get that attitude. Then we have no conflict others, no conflict within. You realize eternal peace within. You can pass on the peace to the whole humanity. You can do that only if you have peace. Pass on this to whole humanity after attaining, realizing your eternal peace within you. Brothers, sisters, Rotarian, thank you very much. If you need any clarification, you can contact me through email. You have all these people, Maithili is there, Arun is there, everyone, you have their contact. You can contact me also. But when you contact, please mention which chapter, which presentation, so that I understand your question clearly. Thanks for this very good attention. It is not just teaching you or presenting you something. I take it as a revision for me. Before my exam, I keep on revising. By not only reading, but talking to somebody else, I am revising. Thanks for your attention. Hari Om. Thank you very much. God bless. Thank you.
Thank you. Wonderful it is.
All goes to my Guru, Paramarthananda.
Yes, absolutely. Thank you, sir.
Now, we can... we have a few questions. Now we move over to the question answer session. I request the participants to type their whatever questions they have in mind in the chat box. I will come to the question in course of time. So currently I have a few questions I need to ask Rotarian Kuppu to clarify about the Gita, what we can learn to help build in peace building and conflict prevention. Rotarian Kuppu, first question, is Gita teaching us to fight war or go for peace? Clarify on this.
Very, very right question. The school students asked me this question in year 2000 in Holland. What do you mean? Krishna told Arjuna to fight war. Does that mean you tell us to go to war? The thing. No. That's why I mentioned in one of the earlier slides, we take it in today's context. The thing. We don't go to that situation. We also read that story and take that day's situation in another angle. Eh? Arjuna, you are the administrator, ruler, you are the police, you are the military. There's a bunch of people doing illegal action and that is affecting the rest of the people. As a police, military, ruler, administrator, you forgive them, chalega, it's okay. Let them be illegal. No, please teach them. If they don't change, punish them. If you go to a judge, okay, you will try to be compassionate, but if somebody is making a big mistake, he's going to punish them. If that person is your own brother, your son or father, whoever it is, he is going to punish them. The police will do the same thing. Military will do the same thing. Punish the wrongdoing people if they don't change, even after repeated advice to them. So it is the situation where Krishna advised them. He went to them many times. Please give them half the country. Please give them 5 villages, 5 houses. And Duryodhana said, I will not give even 5 inches of land. This kind of thing. We'll not go to the story. They didn't change. So when somebody is not changing and doing harmful thing, which is affecting the whole population of that country, state, whatever the thing, you please stop it in one way or other. Okay. So this is in that context. For us, we don't take it that way. Here we are talking, as I mentioned in the slide, there's a big conflict war between our sense organs and sense object, the thing, the world, the thing. So how do we prevent that conflict, the thing? So sense organs become little bit wise, follow the advice of the intellect, buddhi, and do the right thing. I can listen to this, I cannot listen. I can see this, I cannot see that. I can eat it, I cannot eat it. So this is a war between our sense organs and then the world, sense object. And then by following the right advice from buddhi, which is Gita, we control, we fight sense organs and sense object. It's not a fight, it's a conflict. We resolving that conflict. When that conflict is resolved, I cannot do that. I cannot eat that sweet, which is there in that stall, because I'm having high sugar content. But my mind is just going toward that sweet. And my buddhi says, no, don't do that thing. Your sugar is high, you cannot eat sweet. Please take a right turn and go in another direction. Okay. Listen to buddhi, take a right turn and go somewhere. This is what is the teaching of here. Listen to the intellect, rational attitude, and then forget the emotional disturbances. Okay? And then be peaceful at the end. So we are not talking war, etc. We are talking the confrontation. That is it. Turbulence. We are talking conflict. So avoid conflict. Moment you avoid conflict, peace is a natural property of yourself. You don't have to do anything. Conflict avoid, then peace is there. Okay, Arun?
Yeah. Thank you on that. So I guess it appears to be is, first you resolve your inner conflict. Thereafter, it enables you to leave and resolve conflicts in the external world also.
Yeah.
That's a good one. Thank you. I have another question to you. Why Krishna started the second chapter with Jnana Yoga when Karma Yoga is the first step for preparatory level people like me?
Right. I already mentioned in a jocular sense during this presentation. Krishna thought, Arjuna, good friend, cousin, student, so I can start with Jnana Yoga. He thought. It is like that. That's one of the jocular explanation given by this Acharya who are writing Bhashyam. Number two is, another reason is, Jnana Yoga is the ultimate, more strength. If you are not reading full second chapter, you are reading only a little bit. So first cover the Jnana Yoga, the ultimate teaching, first cover the thing. Even when we are making a big project report, the conclusion comes at the end. But what we do is start with the conclusion. I am writing the conclusion of this whole project study, 1, 2, 3, 4 in the first page, and say, I will explain this conclusion in the following 20 pages. We do that thing. Like that, Krishna started about the conclusion first in the first few verses and then started explaining. To come to this Jnana Yoga, you need a pre-qualification Karma Yoga, then go to Karma Yoga, what is Karma Yoga, etc. in the later step, the thing. But in our day-to-day thing, we start from verse 38, from the later part, Karma Yoga first, and then come to verse 11 and 12 later. This is how we should take it in our sense. We put ulta, start reading from the end, like in Arabic, start from the end of the book, other side of the book. Okay.
Okay. Thank you. That clarifies a lot. That first you understand what is the goal of all this, the end purpose and then follow the path laid out to achieve the end goal.
Yeah.
I have the next question is on why did Krishna did not talk about upasana, meditation, for the preparatory level people?
Right. As I mentioned, he did it all in different orders. The thing, upasana is meditation is also a mental karma. When you are talking of karma yoga, do this thing. It's not only action, physical action, it's also mental action, which is upasana, which he thought Arjuna will understand. When you're talking, do the right thing, including right physical thing, right mental thing. Suppose he assumed, then he found that Arjuna didn't understand that way. So upasana is talking very clearly in chapter 6. The chapter 6 itself is called upasana yoga, the thing. Meditation gives a mental focusing. In where karma yoga purify your mind, meditation gives a focusing ability. As I mentioned in that previous presentation, you focus on a object of one, focusing on one thing, the God of your choice, the thing, and focus on the whole universe, the thing. And when you are focusing on the whole, you widening your view, focusing on universe, do it in two steps. See the whole universe in the creator, inside the creator. Then in step two, what you do, see the creator in the whole universe. Before creation, the whole universe is in the creator. In the 11th chapter, Vishwarupa Darshanam, you will see Krishna is standing tall, 1,000 feet tall. The whole world is within him. It's a beginner. Start like that. And then see Krishna in everyone in the world. In you, in me, in he, in she, and all the thing. When we come to this stage of meditation, seeing the creator in everyone, we see everyone equal. I'm seeing God in you, in him, in her, in it, everything I see God. So I treat everyone equal. No liking, no disliking. So I maintain the samatva. So these are the meditation, including the values. I want to act, say, imbibe the values by meditating on the value, like accept people and then contribute to people, compassion, and all those kind of things will slowly, 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 slowly build up in the meditation. It is not mentioned, but it is also come under karma according to Krishna. Since Arjuna didn't understand, he goes for a separate chapter later.
Okay, thank you, Rotarian Cook. I have another question from Rotarian past president Ravindran of our club, Madras Basanaga. His question is very valid. In times of this COVID pandemic, when our body is at risk, how is it possible to follow our mind, especially when you are looking at delivering service to the community through projects?
Yes. The thing, definitely, when I say, we don't say, ignore the body. No, 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 no. You see, don't ignore the body. You need the body, you need the mind, even to understand your real nature is not the body. You are not the body. You are the Atma. To understand that, you need the body. I need a body to go to class. I need my ear to listen to the class. I need my eyes to read the book. I need my legs to walk to the class. The thing. I need my mouth to drink water, to talk freely. You know, that kind of thing. So, body, don't ignore. This is an instrument, but don't ignore the instrument. Your cell phone is an instrument. It is not you. But don't ignore the instrument. Take care of the cell phone. Take care of your car. Take care of your computer. Because it is important to you through computer only or through cell phone only, you are communicating with the world and understanding your real nature. To disclaim the body, to understand your Atma, you need the body. You need the mind to do the thing. So use the body, respect the body, take care of the body. It's very, 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 very important. But don't keep on saying at the end, I am the body. Don't do the thing. Because the body is going to degrade one day or other. It is going to perish one day or other. Why do you get worried? At the age of 40 itself, what will happen when I become 80, 70? Then that will happen. To avoid that, use the body, use the mind, take care of the body, take care of the mind, but don't claim it is you. Take care of your shirt, very, very important, but don't claim you are the shirt. Use the shirt, take care of it, don't throw it, don't tear it, wash it, use it, take care, take care, take care, but realize you are not the shirt. Apply this rule to body-mind complex. This is it. It is not ignoring. You need the body. To serve the community, I need the body. To do the karma yoga, I need the body. So otherwise, I cannot go and do something. So I need the body. I need the mind. That is very important. This is mentioned somewhere. But good question. Thanks, Ravi.
Rotarian Kuppu, kindly stop sharing the screen. I think people would have noted we would like to have your face in full view. So kindly stop sharing your slide so that you will appear in full place. I have one more question is it practical to be balanced for pleasure and pain?
Very difficult question. It's a very, very relevant question. Very difficult for 99.9% of us. Many people said it is easy to say balance it. I get a pleasure today, I get a pain tomorrow. Can I take it equal? Slowly try. Because in the world, to many of us, what happened is if you ask me in the last 73 years, I'm 73 years old, can you split the pleasure and pain? Just a number is just for a discussion. 80%, 90% of the time pain, disappointment. 5, 10, 15, 20% pleasure, happiness. The thing. If I start dancing on pleasure and start crying for pain, the whole life would have been a disappointment, and then let's say we are getting upset, we are getting depressed. This is how it goes. To avoid, because this is how general human life is that. Because every day you ask today somebody, are you happy today evening? No. I expected, yesterday was my birthday, I expected a phone call from my son. He didn't call. It's what the thing. I took care of him for 30, 40 years. He didn't call me to greet my birthday. What kind of son he is? What kind of daughter he is? What kind of brother he is? Disappointment. Then that is how life goes. Instead, if he greets me, if he doesn't greet me, I understand. The thing, he's busy, he's running behind me. Telephone not working, all those kind of things. So the pain also, I take equally. Only I take that attitude. It is not going to happen in a day. I'll start blaming him, shouting at him, and call him and say, why you didn't call and greet me, that kind of thing. Then I reduce my calls. Then slowly. So you cannot make it equal balance in one day. Slowly do that. If somebody says, please avoid, there are doctors, they will say, please avoid this food and add that food. They will tell you. But you will say, I cannot do it in a day. I'll slowly do it. I'll reduce all those fatty stuff and increase all these vegetables, proteins, or vitamins, etc. slowly. But I'll do it slowly. I cannot do it in a day. I cannot totally stop the fat and totally have only vitamins. It's not practical. I'll do it slowly. Like that, we do the pleasure and pain balancing, aram se, slowly. Do that for your own benefit. Try.
Participants, any other questions you would like to ask, you please type in the chat window, because we are at the end of the session. So anybody has any question, please type in the chat window. Do not use the mic. I guess that for the present, it is quite difficult to digest what has been presented. So I guess we look forward to more interaction in the next forthcoming sessions on peace building and
constitution.
I hope Chairperson Rotarian Maithili would agree that this has been successful in communicating to all the Rotarians and non-Rotarians who had participated the concept of peace building and conflict prevention. I look forward to the future sessions too. Now I have my duty. I request our president S. Krishnan of Rotary Club of Madras Visakhapatnam to present the vote of thanks.
Arun, before that I said a few words. Arun, if any Rotarian has any doubt, can they call Rotarian Kuppusami, or is it a disturbance for him? Does he have any specific time? No.
So we have shared his mail ID.
Okay.
Because he will not be able to relate one to one.
Yes.
So I have also typed in the chat box for
Arunji.
Anyone to mail their queries, typing in the subject, so that they can gain clarifications on whatever their doubts.
Arunji.
Okay.
Arunji, na Venkat Raman. Can I say not a few words, only one
thing? Yeah, go ahead.
The first chapter of Gita, I think Kuppu knows about
it. Yeah, go ahead.
First chapter of Gita, Dharma Kshetre Guru Kshetre Samaveda Yujutsavah Mamaha Pandava Chaiva Kimakurvada Sanchaya Sanchaya Uvacha Drishtvad Pandava Nigam Yudam Duryodhanastadah Acharya Mubasangamya Dastan Patnamattadi. Just want to say, great Kuppusop. No other words to say about all this.
Thank you. Thank you, Rotarian Venkat. I request our president to proceed with the vote of thanks.
Ama. Go ahead. Sorry for interruption, Arun.
No.
We just have any questions, anybody in Melcom?
So they take time to think and ask questions.
Yeah. Okay. That's why I think the email
wonderful session. Thank you.
Yeah.
This is not a question, but I think we should all applaud Maithili for this wonderful.
Not at all. Thank you, sir. You're so generous. It is because of the wonderful speaker and Arun and Besanagar, the president, the members. Thank you so much. I'm honored, and Dr. Sriram with his golden hands.
Oh, wonderful. But the foundation is yours.
Thank you.
Okay. Rotarians, you know, Kuppu has been a treasure for our club. He started giving the teachings of Bhagavad Gita right from the day when he joined us. So every year, at least twice, we have a session. It's like a speaker meeting, whether it is in a house or somebody else's house or in a public platform. He shares this. And I think that has benefited all our members. You know, the Rotary Club of Madras Besanagar, which is now almost 25 years old, we are all senior citizens, and being senior citizens, the physical energy levels may be going down, but such kind of sharing of the philosophical teachings keep us mentally alert. And even now, we, as Rabindran, our chair, he's so enthusiastic. We are about to do a global grand project very soon. I think all this is because Kuppu keeps us calm and sees that we get our energy through these kinds of sessions. So I would like to thank my friend so much so I call him now, although I am more or less the same age as him, but still I think I have no hesitation to in my mind to call him as my guru. I would like to extend my thanks to Rotarian Maithili. I have met her in my center, that is I am associated with a center called Madhuram Narayanan Center for Exceptional Children. When she started the Indica project, the first project which she did was at our center. That was my first experience with her. And the way she went about that project with so much of enthusiasm, with so much of sensitivity to the to our children and to the project, I am at loss of words to tell her. So as Dr. Sriram said, whatever she is going to take, she puts her heart and soul into it. So I have no doubt that this series, which is going to go on for the entire year, is also going to be successful with the support of Rotarian Maithili. I have to thank Dr. Sriram for an excellent beginning which he has made. He laid a kind of a foundation and made us understand what, in a nutshell, what this session is going to be. The few minutes which he spent and he in his inaugural speech, I'm sure that he has also studied Bhagavad Gita quite well. I mean, a person who reads and it's just not reading. He must have studied it. And that is how when the inauguration took place, he could give the essence of that Gita, which paved the way for Kupu's presentation. Lastly, but not least, I thank all the Rotarians on behalf of our Rotary Club of Madras, my members, secretary, on behalf of everybody. I thank the district for making us as the host club, and I thank all the Rotarians who have willingly participated. And as word spreads, I'm sure during the next few sessions, we will have more participants for this club. With this, I would like to conclude this session. And if anybody else has anything, anybody would like to comment, otherwise, I adjourn the meeting. Thank you.
Wonderful
thank
session.
You. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Sriram. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Sriram.
Thank you, Doctor.
Thank you, Doctor. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Maithili.
Yes, my pleasure. Thank you, sir. Guruji.
I must also I must thank Arun, who has taken this initiative of taking this forward on behalf of our club. Being a director of public image, I think our credit goes to him to introduce Kupu and the district. Yes. Thank you, Arun.
Thank you.
This is a very unique program in 3232, I think. First time we are doing one like this.
I believe we have made some headway in conflict resolution.
Yes, yes. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you. I am ending the session. So thank you.
Thank you. See you on next October, first week, Sunday.
Yes, madam.
Yes, for the second session, third and fourth chapters.
Oh, fantastic.
7:15 to 12:15. Confirmed.